What is happening, everybody? James Hancock here, back to review The Lodge, starring Riley Keough, which opens this weekend. I've been calling her Riley Keough for years, which is apparently not the way to say it, but it's Elvis's granddaughter, so let's get this right. But I got into an advanced screening last night at the Angelica here in New York, and the movie had been on my radar for quite a while in that I thoroughly enjoyed the last film by the filmmaking team, Severin Fiala and Veronica Franz. But this is a tough movie to review without spoiling, in that even discussing the plot is a huge challenge without giving anything massive away. Within minutes, this movie features a really shocking scene that I don't want to ruin for anyone, so initially I'll do my best to be vague about plot points and only mention information that was featured in the trailer, and then I'll give you fair warning before any spoilers. But this is a movie about what happens when a father leaves his two children and his new girlfriend alone together for a few days in his mountain house, hoping that they'll learn to get along. Christmas is right around the corner, but the kids don't like Riley Keough's character at all, especially so once they learn that as a girl, she was the sole survivor of a religious cult that was involved in a mass suicide. To make matters even more tense, the three of them are soon trapped in the house without electricity, cut off from the outside world due to a massive snowstorm. As fear, bad dreams, and cabin fever start to set in, it soon becomes clear that they're all in quite a bit of danger, but the question is whether or not any of them are responsible for the strange events taking place under their roof, or is there something that's out to get them? Now, I try to avoid using the expression art house horror whenever possible, but when it comes to the type of audience that a movie like this will appeal to, art house horror is probably as good a way to describe this movie as any. This movie is not going after the audience that's into movies like A Quiet Place or Halloween, It, The Conjuring, or any other big horror franchise you can think of. This is going after the kind of crowd that likes horror movies like Hereditary. With that in mind, I regret to say I don't think The Lodge is anywhere near as good as Hereditary, nor do I think it's as effective as Goodnight Mommy, the previous film. There were plenty of scenes that gave me the heebie-jeebies, and I remain a massive fan of Riley Keough, but this film never quite manages to find that special gear where it becomes truly terrifying or overwhelming. But I must admit that a small part of my frustration with the movie stems from an unfortunate incident that happened at the screening. As a special treat, the Angelica invited the filmmakers for a Q&A after the movie, something I was genuinely excited for. But about halfway through the movie, I started to hear quite a racket behind one of the exit doors, and I just assumed that this was part of the normal chaos of seeing a movie in New York, where subway trains or delivery trucks or all kinds of things can interfere with the movie-going experience. But then, right as the movie is about to reach its climax at the very end, suddenly, this exit door opened, flooding the screening room with light, and I saw these knuckleheads holding director's chairs and microphones, basically morons who had jumped the gun on setting up all the equipment they needed for the Q&A. They immediately backed up, and when they did, they left the door partially open, annoying the ever-living shit out of me due to the light that was continuing to shine in. So I got up, I pulled the door shut, which prompted a bunch of laughter from the crowd, but by the time I returned to my seat, the credits were rolling. I'd missed the last scene, and to say I was pissed would be the understatement of the century. While not blown away by the movie, I was invested and really wanted to see if the movie would end on some big shocking revelation. And ordinarily, the Angelica is one of the best art house theaters in New York, but they have definitely made my shit list for the time being. But all that frustration aside, which obviously has nothing to do with the content of the film, it's tough for me to make an ironclad case that people need to rush out and see this movie this weekend unless they are straight up dying to see it. I don't think the film is nearly as narratively coherent or as emotionally impactful as Goodnight Mommy. I enjoyed it, but in an era with so much intense competition for our eyeballs, I can't honestly say that horror fans absolutely must throw down their hard-earned money to see the movie this weekend unless the trailer makes it look like the kind of movie that is 100% right up your alley. But let's talk some spoilers, because there are a few scenes where this movie really got under my skin. The big question early on, as the power goes out and the food starts to vanish, is whether or not Riley Keough's character is going insane, or is she being tormented by the kids to try and make her lose it? The answer, as it turns out, is both. The kids hide the medication that she so desperately needs, and they start to tell her that they all died in this ice skating accident and are now trapped in purgatory until they repent. And initially, she calls them out on their BS, but after going too long without her pills and losing her little dog to a prank that has gone way too far, she ends up falling back into the religious hysteria from her childhood and starts plotting a way for them all to die in a mass suicide so that they can ascend to heaven together. The kids are basically way more successful than they anticipated from their little prank, as Keough's character goes completely batshit insane, far more so than they could have hoped for. And overall, I think the cast does a really good job. Lea McHugh's an excellent child actress, while Jade Martell easily matches his performance as the young Bill Denbrough in It. Richard Armitage might be a little flat, but he's barely in the movie, until Riley Keough blows his brains out. The big surprise for me was seeing Alicia Silverstone in action again. She gets her brains blown out as well, but she does it to herself when she learns that her husband's leaving her for a much younger woman. That early jolt definitely gets the movie going with a literal bang. The movie also features a few hair-raising scenes that I really enjoyed, like a fun night where they all get freaked out watching John Carpenter's remake of The Thing. Even better is a found footage sequence of the suicide cult that the kids find online. But the film's probably at its best during these really intense dream sequences as Keough stumbles around the cabin in the dark, not quite knowing what's real and what's not. Riley Keough more than pulls her weight as the lead in the film. But the big problem for me is that the movie feels like it's building and building and building toward this big emotional peak that never quite arrives. Keough gets lost in the snow at one point looking for help and basically loses her mind completely in the process, probably the most stylish and atmospheric scene of the movie. But it wouldn't surprise me at all if just as many people out there are bored by the experience as those who find it riveting. I still have a ton of faith in this filmmaking team and will continue to see their movies, but I'm going to chalk up The Lodge as a very ambitious, creative movie that doesn't quite come together for a completely satisfying experience. So I wish I had a more favorable review to report about this movie, but sadly, it just didn't quite do it for me. But once again, if you see the trailer and it looks like it's made specifically for you, definitely go see it. There's some very good things going on in this movie. But I think I'm going to go ahead and sign off. So if you want to talk more about horror movies or Riley Keough or The Lodge or whatever, you can always find me on Twitter at Cole Brex, or just leave me a comment in the comments below. But if you enjoyed this review, please consider subscribing to the channel and hitting that notification button. I only learned recently that a lot of my reviews are not showing up for people who subscribe to my channel unless they hit the notification button. In any event, can't thank you enough for watching my review. I really appreciate it. But more importantly, as always, onwards and upwards.